metals react with acid. Now, metals are those which have good tendency to get oxidized. Means metals have good tendency to donate electrons. Means metals are those which have good tendency, high tendency, capacity to get converted into positively charged ions, into cations. So the elements which have good tendency to get converted into positively charged ions by donating electrons, by releasing electrons to others, to donate electrons, to get converted into positively charged ions, cations, means releasing of electrons, donating of electrons is oxidation as per the definition. Those are metals. So sodium or magnesium, or the example aluminium which we have taken, all are metals. When reacted with acid, it can be any other acid also. What is fixed? Metals with acids get converted into, because in acid, hydrogen carries, this is HCl, hydrogen carries plus one charge, chlorine minus one, this is plus one, this is minus one, this is plus one, this is minus one. If during a reaction, metal with acid, metal with free H plus ion from acid, or metal with water, metal with oxygen, metal on this side, which carries oxidation number, elemental form, zero. On other side, one thing is common, any metal, metal with H plus ion, means suppose that it is sodium with H plus, it will form, it will donate one electron, because sodium has capacity to donate one electron. And this electron will be captured by, the electron will be accepted by H plus, one H plus accepts electron, therefore we get nascent hydrogen. Now such nascent hydrogen atoms combine to give H2 gas, therefore I can multiply this by 2, 2 sodium react with 2 H plus, giving rise to 2 nascent hydrogen. 2 nascent hydrogen means I can write it in the form of H2. Similarly, if it is Mg, one magnesium element in elemental form, oxidation state is zero, with H plus ions, free H plus ions from acid, one magnesium has tendency to get converted into, its oxidation number is plus 2, as we have already covered it. Means one magnesium makes available 2 electrons. Those 2 electrons will be accepted by one each by H plus, and therefore what we get is 2 nascent hydrogen atoms. Such 2 nascent hydrogen atoms combine to give H2 gas. Similarly, one aluminium, when reacted with H plus ions, free H plus ions from acid, has tendency to get converted into plus 3 ion. So each aluminium ion will make available 3 electrons. And such 3 H plus ions will react separately with 3 electrons to give 3 nascent hydrogen atoms. Now nascent hydrogen atoms, 2 will combine to give H2 gas. So to balance it, one aluminium atom in presence of acid or in presence of free H plus ions makes available 3 electrons. If such 2 are present, then total electrons available will be 6. Then I have to multiply this also by 2. and therefore nascent hydrogen can be returned in the form of H2 gas. So this, for this to explain it or write it properly, let me rub this now. So this can be written, aluminium, 2 aluminium will react with 6 H plus ions, and what we get is 2 ions of aluminium and 6 nascent hydrogen atoms, means ultimately 3 H2 gas. Now this chemistry, metal with free H plus from free H plus ions from acid, if it is known and studied separately, then such type of reactions, overall reactions, to write it, it becomes easy. So I will write, now if Na changes to Na plus 1, means it will form compound with minus 1 Cl, it will get converted into Cl minus. And Na0 changes to Na plus 1, cation, elemental sodium, zero oxidation number changes to Na plus 1. This electron is accepted by H plus, just now I have told you. Nascent hydrogen, and nascent hydrogen atom will get converted to H2 gas, so let me balance it now. One more sodium, one more molecule, giving rise to. Now once whatever I have told you earlier is known to you, then I can write it. Yes. And just now I have told you, aluminium 0, on that side it changes to plus 3. So such 2 aluminium atoms, if they are present, 2 aluminium ions and 1 aluminium plus 3. Just now, I have told you that aluminium in its elemental form, unreacted form, carries oxidation number 0, and when reacted with acid, when reacted with water, it changes to plus 3. So aluminium, if it changes to plus 3, means it donates 3 electrons. And HCl, in HCl, hydrogen carries plus 1, chlorine carries minus 1. This plus 3 aluminium will get converted into AlCl3. 1 plus 3 requires 3 minus 1 chloride ions, minus 1 charge carrying. And 2 aluminium, if we take, then it will give rise to such 2 plus 3 aluminium. Means AlCl3 molecule, 2 such AlCl3 molecules will be present. So in all, electrons available are 6. So it will react with 6 HCl, means H plus ions, 6 will react with 6 electrons and get converted into 6 nascent hydrogen atoms, giving rise to 3H2. If this chemistry, which we have earlier considered it separately, if it is known, then we can write this equation. So aluminium with HCl, writing directly, twice aluminium plus 6 HCl, giving rise to AlCl3 twice plus 3H2. Writing this reaction directly, memorizing, is not difficult for 10 students, but this is not a way to learn chemistry. We should learn in this fashion. And then exam point of view and your 10th, in addition to that, you can use your memory. If this method is used, this will develop your chemical logic, and future study of chemistry becomes interesting and easy. As we know, metal react with acid, metal react with water, metal react with oxygen, and metals get converted into their corresponding cations. This is general representation. Positive ions. It can be plus 1 like sodium, potassium, Ag. It can be plus 2 like magnesium, calcium. It can be plus 3 like aluminium, ferric, Fe plus 3, Al plus 3. Any metal. Metal react with oxygen. Metal react with elemental. Earlier it was 0 oxidation number. It react with water. So metal with oxygen, metal will change to its corresponding positively charged ion, cation, and electrons are released. And oxygen will accept electrons. One oxygen atom has capacity to accept 2 electrons. Although such free ion is not present, but in the compound, the charge on the oxygen is minus 2. That is why I have written in this fashion or here also. So if we consider the balancing of reaction in which metal reacts with oxygen, metal will get converted into its positively charged ion, cation, and oxygen will get converted into its oxide. One oxygen will carry minus 2 charge. If one molecule is there, means such, each one will carry, hold, attract, gain 2 electrons, such 2 are there. So once this is known, then it is quite clear that sodium has capacity to get converted into. So such 2 sodium atoms, if they are taken, they will make available 2 electrons. Or if such 4 sodium atoms are taken, they will make available 4 electrons, will give 4 Na plus ions plus 4 electrons. And one molecule of oxygen requires 4 electrons. So 4 sodium with one molecule of oxygen, one molecule, it has 2 atoms of oxygen, will get converted into the formula, because one oxygen carries minus 2 charge. So plus 1 sodium, such 2, will make Na twice O. And therefore, if I taken here 4 and 1 molecule of oxygen, 2 atoms of sodium and 1 atom of oxygen, so in all, the coefficient will be 2. Now with magnesium, one magnesium has capacity to get converted into plus 2, giving 2 electrons. And therefore, it will react with one oxygen atom. And therefore, MgO is formed. But at a time, oxygen is available in the form of O2 molecule, 1O2, 2O2, 3O2. Therefore, I will take coefficient 2. MgO, such 2 molecules are formed. Now with aluminium, we can balance aluminium in similar way. One aluminium atom has capacity to make available 3 electrons. And one oxygen atom has capacity to accept 2 electrons. So to balance electronically, if I take aluminium 2 atoms, electrons available will be 6. And if I take 6, if I take 3 oxygen atoms, electrons captured will be 6. But oxygen, since it is present in the form of O2, 2O2 or 3O2, means I can multiply this by 4, then aluminium, if taken, are 4, 12 electrons, then it becomes easy to balance, because aluminium oxide plus 3 aluminium and minus 2 oxygen, the compound, the molecular formula for the compound comes to be this. And so, but oxygen, one molecule, two molecule, three molecule, 2 atoms of oxygen, 4 atoms, 6 atoms. So if I take coefficient 2 here and coefficient 3 here, such 2 molecules are formed. Now, I have explained in a bit speedy way, because the basics for this, understanding such type of reactions, is covered. So this is how the reactions should be studied and balanced.